Come alive.
Love some moanings, feel the empty sheets. Yeah, and it comes on without warning, like the air I breathe. And I must have done something right.
You come round here, Mr. Tedder.
Yeah, mate.
I'm in my bag, so I can't.
Mate, it's been authentic with myself. That's what it's about, yeah. Right, guys, so we're here with the man Lee Tedder today. We're at his gym, Reform, which is also in Huddersfield, funnily enough. And we're going to get some legs in. So here's the man Lee. Do you want to say anything, Lee? Awesome, let's get into it. So we're starting today, we're doing legs today, and we're starting with hip adductors. So the reason being, or one of the main reasons being, as well as just warming up the hip in general, is when we go onto our hack squat, they don't actually have a hack squat, they have a V squat. When we go onto that, we'll actually be able to get a little bit deeper, a little bit better range of motion. So usually people, the two places where people struggle with range is ankle and hip, and this just deals with the hip. I want to see a bit more engagement at the front.
Okay.
Almost like your shagging machine a little bit. But keep it shagged. Keep it shagged. Yes. Nicely. Yep, everything calm. Nicely. Well done, bro. Yep. Nice. I'm on the fucking crispy chunks, so I have to do another set, mate. Anabolic crispy chunks, aka trend bars. So you gotta do one more set. Easily, come on. Come on. Legs on this guy. Pause, grass it up. Nice. He dies. When you get towards the back end of a set and you're going to failure, and how the set naturally slows down even though you don't want it to.
Yeah.
That's one of the positive things of it. So when you're doing the spot, the spot's good, but you want to give it just enough to where it keeps going.
Right, don't go balls out.
Yeah. Yeah, not like a save. Not like, if it's like powerlifting, it's like, well, it's clearly not meant to be a grab, you're not meant to fail.
Yeah,
but in this,
we you're just going to slowly help you up.
Yeah, basically just make the cuts off for a bit. Yeah. Right, what do you have next?
Leg extension.
Awesome. I usually have deadlifts, which I'm kind of happy we're not doing. Done my time with them fuckers. So 4 seconds down, 2 seconds up, pause at top. Let's get it, mate. Come on, Tedder. Yep. Look how sharp the corner of that calf raise is. This must be the secret to calves like Lee Tedder. Dorian Yates, eat your heart out. Check out fucking Lee Tedder's calves. He says you get them from being 125 kilos, but in actual fact, it's from fucking doing barefoot calf raises on knives. Mate, put my Crocs on for the next set.
You what?
I've got to put my Crocs on for the next set. Fucking feet, it's getting sliced. This guy's feet are made of alamantium. If you don't know what that is, watch Wolverine. Wolverine's, is it, what's it called? The origin story, do you know what it is there? Watch X-Men. Or don't. Pass me my dad jump. If you want to get your rope crunches right, all you want to think about is, on the way up, think chest forwards. So when you think chest forwards, it basically extends your upper back. Basically it's a stretch on your abs. Then when you come down, think of headbutting yourself in the nuts. And if you don't have nuts, obviously, don't headbutt yourself in the nuts, okay? But you know what I'm saying? The function of the abs in this movement is to basically just round your spine as much as possible and extend. Oftentimes, I'll get people that will just hinge, like they're doing a Romanian deadlift or something. This is one of the only exercises in the gym where you actually want to bend your back, okay?
Back in, I think it was back in October, last year, when we were on holiday in Domrep, I kind of reached out to Christian a little bit, but didn't take it on. I just inquired, and just let myself get worse after my holiday. I think I topped out about 125 kg at the end of last year. So New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, I was 125 kg, and went. Had a bit of a word to myself and said, right, I can do this on my own. I did a month on my own and got to about 120, but things were creeping up again. Things were massively spiraling out of control again. So I reached out to Christian in the beginning of March this year, and not looked back since. Since then, we've done a diet phase and dropped 20 kg with Christian, so total loss of 25 kg, or as I call it, a bag of cement. And yeah, it's the effects that's had on me as a person is unbelievable. I do a lot of outdoor activities, loads of walking, loads of mountaineering, mountain rescue as well, and I always, at the end of last year, I was struggling to do that. I mean, I couldn't walk without being in constant pain. I was struggling to do my water rescue. I was struggling to do a lot of things, and just put a smile on it and a brave face, and just went, yeah, fuck it, it'll be all right. But inside, my head was saying, you can do it, but my body was saying no. And probably now, probably from getting down to where we were my lowest at 100 kg, now what I know I can do it, whatever my head says I can do, I can do it. My walking is fucking second to none. I'm like a bloody racing snake now up on the fells. As before, times were so slow. Running, the start of this year, I couldn't run for 2 minutes without being in agonising pain. Now I can 3 miles in 30 minutes. So the improvements is massive. And it's all mindset. And I know I've said to Kristen a few times, it's a lot of it is mindset. Once you get into that routine of the food, the working out, that's the easy bit because he tells you what to do, and he's really good at it. He's really really positive. You know, if you're doing shit, he'll tell you you're doing shit. If you're doing really well, he strives on you and he brings out the best in you. He's definitely brought out the best in me, and my mindset's like second to none. yeah, we just keep going. Coming up in the future, what we've got reverse diet phase now. So we do that for another 9-10 weeks, see where we end up at that, and then we cut back down. But there's big things coming, massive things coming. I'm finishing my weighing rights at this bank holiday, which is a 10-year journey ended. And then we'll look to move on and progress to do 50-mile like ultra runs and walks and stuff like that in the next year. So yeah, we're coming along, big things coming. But I can't thank Christian enough. And you know, yeah, they say it's not just Christian, but it's home people as well. You know, everybody at home, the wife, the kids, you know, all that. You know, they support me through this journey as well. So yeah, that's about it, really.
Yeah, fucking ass, man.
You know what I mean?
Cheers, Lee.
That's all right, man.
Right, guys. So that was Legs with Mr. Lee Tedder. Fucking great guy. Absolutely love him. We've got some big goals for him for 2024. I told him he's going to get abs for 2024. He says he's not that bothered, he just wants to be functionally fit and like an absolute machine. But yeah, I've got big goals for him. Over 45 pounds he's lost so far. I haven't even been working together that long. I think he started in like March, but yeah, absolute G. But yeah, no, just got home. Post-workout meal. We've got 185 grams of Cocoa Pops, 100 grams of banana, 170 chicken, supposed to have whey, but I fucking run out. I'm a spaz. Then we've got a crispy chunk, aka Poverty Squares bar, can of pop, 2 grams of pink salt, and that's it. And we're just going to finish up the day, do a bit of work, have a look through my to-do list, respond to some clients, and that's it. But yeah, guys, if you liked the video, please like it, share it, subscribe, all that good stuff. Put it on your stories and Instagram, that'd be a fucking massive help. So if you do actually want to see me do more of these, people actually have to watch them to make it worth it. So if you could share it, I'd absolutely buzz off that, and I'd really appreciate it. So yeah, big love, and I'll see you next time. Take care.